everyone, welcome back to my class. This is Romana Ali. I hope you all are doing well. In today's class, I'm going to explain you about the apiculture. In the last class, we have seen how we can get the different products from the animals. Like we have studied about the milk production as well as about the poultry. Now in today's class, let us study about apiculture. Apiculture means rearing and management of honeybees. So honeybees are also the insects from which we can get the food items. We can get the food like honey from the honeybees, which is full of nutrients. So honeybees are the insects that sucks the nectar of the different flowers, and that nectar is being added up by some chemicals. And after adding some chemicals in that nectar, this nectar is stored in the natural beehives or in the artificial beehives. Artificial beehives can also be set up to store the nectar that is collected by the honeybees. So we can collect the honey from the beehives that are present naturally or that are built naturally on the trees or on the higher places, that is on the roofs and on the trees. We can see the presence of beehives. And sometimes certain people, they take their beehives and they collect the honey which is present or which is stored in the beehives for the future use by the honeybees. In this way, the collection of the honey can be done by taking the beehives. So the honey is stored in the beehives, either in the natural beehives or in the artificial beehives. Before we study about the apiculture in detail, or before we see what are the other different products that we get from the honeybees, let us talk about the honeybees first. So honeybees are the social insects like the ants, and they show a good communication. So as they communicate with each other very well, we can say that these are social insects. So these honeybees, they show the groups. We can find the presence of queen bee in their group, drones and workers. So queen bees are the bees, and the lifespan of the queen bee is 2 to 3 years. And the role of this queen bee is to lay eggs. So this queen bee can be able to lay 800 to 1200 eggs per year. And these eggs are hatched by the other bees. So the drones are the male bees. They do not have any role to play except mating with the female. These male insects mate with the female, and then the female lay the eggs. The lifespan of the drones is 57 days. The next one is workers. Worker bees are the bees who can leave for 5 to 6 weeks. And the role of these worker bees is to collect the nectar and to protect the eggs. The eggs which are laid by the queen bee, they are hatched and reared by these worker bees. So here we can find the three types of bees in the group of honeybees. The first one is queen bee. Queen bee, the lifespan of the queen bee is 2 to 3 years. And the role of this queen bee is to lay eggs. They can lay 800 to 1200 eggs per year. The next one is drones. These are the male bees, and their function is mating with the females. And the lifespan of this drones is 57 days. The workers are also the bees who can live up to 5 to 6 weeks. Their role is to collect the nectar and to hatch and rear the eggs which are laid by the queen bee. So this is about the different types of bees that are present in the group of honeybees and their functions. So abhi hum baat karenge apiculture ke bare mein. Apiculture yani rearing or managing the honeybees. Honeybees ko protect karna aur unko raise karna, is cheez ko hum bolenge apiculture. Honeybees aise insects hai jo hume honey dete hain, honey provide karte hain. Honey ek aisa food item hai jisme bahut sare nutrients present hote hain. Honeybees nectar collect karte hain flowers mein se, aur wo nectar ko store kiya jata hai beehives mein. Beehives natural bhi hote hain aur artificially bhi beehives ko set up kiya ja sakta hai. अब बात करेंगे हनीबीज के बारे में. पहले तो हनीबीज ऐसे इंसेक्ट्स हैं जिसको हम सोशल इंसेक्ट्स बोल सकते हैं, क्योंकि वो एक दूसरे से अच्छे से कम्युनिकेट कर पाते हैं. और ग्रुप ऑफ हनीबीज में तीन तरह के बीज प्रेजेंट होते हैं. एक है क्वीन बी, एक है ड्रोन्स और एक है वर्कर्स. क्वीन बी यानी ऐसे बीज जो कि 2 to 3 ईयर्स उन लोगों का लाइफ स्पैन होता है और जो एग्स को ले करते हैं. और ये क्वीन बी 800 to 1200 एग्स पर ईयर देते हैं, ठीक है। तो ड्रोन्स का एक ही फंक्शन है जो कि है कॉपुलेशन, दैट मींस मेटिंग विद द फीमेल, और इनका लाइफ स्पैन है 57 डेज। और वर्कर्स ऐसे बीज होते हैं जो 5 to 6 वीक्स तक ही लीव कर पाते हैं, और इनका काम है कि ये नेक्टर को कलेक्ट करते हैं और जो एग्स ले करती है क्वीन बी, वो वाले एग्स को हैच और रेयर करने के लिए भी वर्कर बीज हेल्प करते हैं। सो दिस इज अबाउट द हनी बीज एंड द डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ बीज दैट आर प्रेजेंट इन द ग्रुप ऑफ हनी बीज। ओके, लेट अस सी व्हाट आर द डिफरेंट वैरायटीज ऑफ हनी बीज दैट कैन बी फाउंड इन इंडिया। सो द डिफरेंट वैरायटीज that are present in India are Apis dorsata, Apis indica, Apis flora, Apis melipona, Apis trigona and Apis serena. Among all these, Apis serena is a variety of honeybees that can be able to collect 3 to 10 kgs of nectar. So this much amount of nectar can be collected by the Apis serena variety. And Apis mellifera is a variety. Apis mellifera is an European variety. So this type of honeybees, they can collect 25 to 30 kgs of nectar. Okay, so they can collect 25 to 30 kgs of nectar from the different flowers. So the honeybees, they usually visit the different kinds of plants to carry out the process of collection of nectar. So, in the process of collecting nectar, they visit the different kinds of plants and they suck the nectar from the flowers of that plant, and that nectar which is sucked or which is collected in the mouth of the honeybees, they bring that nectar and they store in the beehives. After collection of the nectar from the different kinds of plants, so from where do they collect the nectar? They collect the nectar from the plants like fruit plants, and also from the vegetable plants and from the ornamental plants. They usually collect the nectar from the flowers of orange, apple, berries, citrus. They visit such kind of plants and they suck the nectar of the flowers of these plants, and that nectar is stored in the beehives. After collection of the nectar, they mix up the nectar with certain chemical enzymes. So, in their mouth, some chemical enzymes are present that are mixed up with the nectar, and it results in the formation of honey. If in case the honeybees, they get the nectar from the same kind of flowers, then the taste will be different. The taste of the honey will be different, but generally, they collect the nectar from the different kinds of plants, and that nectar is mixed up with some chemical enzymes, and then it becomes honey which can be collected and which can be consumed by the human being. So, in this way, the honey is produced by the honeybees and it is stored in the beehives. From the beehives, we can get the honey or we can collect the honey. Apart from the honey, honeybees are also useful in providing the different things. So, we can get the bee venom by which we can make the venom tincture, which is a medicine. Whenever the honeybee bites a person, then they get severe pain and infection. So to cure that type of infection, venom tincture can be used as a medicine. And apart from this, honeybees are also used in producing bee wax, and this bee wax is used in making certain polishes. So this bee wax which we get from the honeybees, it can be used to make certain polishes and also to make the different creams. These are some of the uses or the products that we get from the honeybees. तो अभी हम बात करेंगे वराइटीज ऑफ हनी बीज जो कि इंडिया में प्रेजेंट होते हैं, और वो है एपिस डॉर्सिटा, एपिस इंडिका, एपिस फ्लोरा, एपिस मेलिपोना, एपिस ट्रिगोना और एपिस सेरिना। एपिस सेरिना ऐसी वराइटी है जो 3 to 10 केजीज ऑफ नेक्टर कलेक्ट करती है, और एपिस मेलिफेरा एक यूरोपियन वराइटी है हनी बीज की जो कि 25 to 30 केजीज ऑफ नेक्टर कलेक्ट करते हैं डिफरेंट प्लांट से। अब प्रोसीजर देखेंगे कि किस तरह से हनी प्रोड्यूस किया जाता है, किस तरह से हनी का प्रोडक्शन होता है विद द हेल्प ऑफ हनी बीज। तो पहले तो हनी बीज नेक्टर कलेक्ट करते हैं डिफरेंट फ्लावर्स से, सक करते हैं नेक्टर, और वो फ्लावर्स और वो प्लांट्स होंगे फ्रूट और वेजिटेबल्स के, ऑर्नामेंटल प्लांट्स के फ्लावर्स में से भी नेक्टर कलेक्ट किया जाता है। ऑरेंज, एप्पल, बेरीज, सिट्रस, ये सारे फ्रूट ट्रीज के फ्लावर्स में से भी नेक्टर कलेक्ट किया जाता है। नेक्टर को कलेक्ट करने के बाद में उसको बीहाइव में स्टोर किया जाता है, और बीहाइव में स्टोर करने से पहले उसको थोड़े से केमिकल एंजाइम से मिक्स किया जाता है। तो जो केमिकल एंजाइम्स हनी बीज के माउथ में प्रेजेंट होते हैं, वो वाले एंजाइम्स नेक्टर में ऐड किए जाते हैं और फिर उसको बीहाइव में स्टोर किया जाता है, और इस तरह से हनी बनाया जाता है। और बीहाइव में जो हनी स्टोर किया हुआ होता है वो ह्यूमंस के कंजम्पशन के लिए कलेक्ट किया जा सकता है। हनी के अलावा भी दूसरे ऐसे प्रोडक्ट्स हैं जो कि बहुत ज़्यादा यूज़फुल है जो हनी बीज से मिलते हैं, और वो है बी विनोम। बी विनोम से हम विनोम टिंक्चर एक मेडिसिन है बना सकते हैं। ये वाली मेडिसिन इन्फेक्शंस को, हनी बी के काटने से जो भी इन्फेक्शन होता है उसको क्योर करने के लिए हेल्प करता है ये वाला मेडिसिन विनोम टिंक्चर। बी वैक्स भी एक ऐसा प्रोडक्ट है जो कि हनी बी से ही मिलेगा, और ये वाले प्रोडक्ट से कई तरह के क्रीम्स और पॉलिशेस बनाए जा सकते हैं। सो दिस इज अबाउट द डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ वराइटीज दैट आर फाउंड इन इंडिया एंड ऑल्सो अबाउट द डिफरेंट प्रोडक्ट्स दैट वी गेट फ्रॉम द हनी बीज। एपिकल्चर हैज अ थ्रेट ऑफ पेस्ट्स लाइक इन द केस ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर। So there are certain pests that can kill the honeybees or that can damage the bee colonies. And that pests are wax moths, wasps, robber flies, dragon flies, king crow, bee eaters. All such pests can harm the honeybees or can kill the honeybees. So they should be protected from all these pests. So as these pests can attack or they can damages the bee colonies, the bee colonies and also the honeybees, they should be protected from all these pest attack. So let us discuss about the fisheries. Fish is an important food item which is full of nutrients or which provides many different kinds of proteins to the humans. If we look at the India, then the coastal line covers 7500 kilometers of area. That means 1.4 million square kilometer of area can be seen as the coastal line. Apart from this coastal areas, the inland water bodies are also present, and inland water bodies includes rivers, ponds or lakes. In the inland water bodies also, we can go for the fishing. The fishing can be done in the coastal areas as well as in the inland water area. Apart from this natural water bodies that are present for fisheries, there are some other artificial setup to do the fishing activity. So the farmers in their agricultural land, they set up some ponds, artificial ponds, where they rear different kinds of fishes and prawns. And when we see the varieties of prawns that are present in the artificial ponds set up by the farmers, then among that, the tiger prawns are the ones that are very beneficial, and they are very useful in getting more and more commercial production. That means they are grown for commercial purposes. So this is about the fisheries. Fishing activity can be done in the inland water bodies as well as in the artificial setups. Let us see what are the different local varieties that are present, and these local varieties includes Murrel, Katla, Katrana, Rohu, Sear. All these kinds of local varieties can be found in the inland water bodies. In the marine water bodies, we can find the presence of varieties like mackerel, tuna, sardines, Bombay duck. So these local varieties are grown for commercial purposes, and these marine varieties are of good food value. That means the food value of all these marine varieties is very much high when compared to the local varieties. So they are grown for the consumption by the human beings. And when the farmers or the other persons, when they go for fishing, they usually go in the boat. That means they sit in the boat and they enter into the sea. And with the help of the different nets, they collect the different fishes, and they have an idea that in this particular place they can find this kind of fishes. So by having an idea, they can go for fishing by using the nets. So with the help of nets, they can collect the different varieties of the fishes from the different water bodies, that is from the freshwater lakes as well as from the marine water systems. But fishing may become problematic because of the bad weather conditions. This is about the fisheries. Fisheries yani fishes ko rare karna aur unko grow karna commercial purposes ke liye ya fir human ke consumption ke liye. इंडिया में 7500 किलोमीटर यानी 1.4 मिलियन स्क्वायर किलोमीटर ऑफ कोस्टल एरिया प्रेजेंट है और इनलैंड वाटर बॉडीज जैसे कि है रिवर्स पॉन्ड्स और लेक्स भी प्रेजेंट है जिसके अंदर फिशिंग एक्टिविटी की जा सकती है और आर्टिफिशियल पॉन्ड्स भी सेटअप किए जाते हैं जिसके अंदर फिशेज और प्रॉन्स को रेयर किया जाता है और जब लोकल वराइटीज की बात करेंगे तो ये सारे लोकल वराइटीज़ है जो कि प्रेजेंट होते हैं जिसको कमर्शियल पर्पसेस के लिए ग्रो किया जाता है और मराइन वराइटीज़ भी है जैसा कि मैक्रल टोना सार्डाइंस बॉम्बे डक ये सारों की फूड वैल्यू बहुत ज़्यादा हाई है तो इनको कंज्यूम करके कई तरह के प्रोटीन्स को हम इंक्लूड कर सकते हैं हमारी डाइट में मीट यू नेक्स्ट क्लास थैंक यू